London Waterloo Station kind of accidentally became a terminus station. So what happened? Well, first of all,
let's go back.
The London Waterloo Station, formerly known as Waterloo Bridge Station, opened in 1848 by the London and South Western Railway, and it was created to replace what was the former terminus over at Nine Elms. It was in this vicinity where the original Nine Elms terminus station was. So when London Waterloo Station opened, it was actually connected to the London South Eastern Railway. The intention was to allow more services from the southwest to connect with the southeast. But given the popularity of London Waterloo Station, that was somewhat short-lived. To allow increased capacity of London Waterloo Station, the lines through the station were demolished. Now, I could spend all day talking about the history of London Waterloo Station, but here's some of my highlights. So something that's more in recent memory was that London Waterloo used to be the terminus of Eurostar up until 2007, when HS1 was brought into St Pancras International, as we know it as today. There are still videos online of the Eurostar services going through stations such as like Bromley South, for example.
The next train at this platform is not for customer use.
Which I always find quite fascinating if you're waiting for a commuter service and you see this Eurostar train pass. London Waterloo Station was also the terminus of the London Necropolis Railway, which is a railway for dead people. No, seriously, it was a railway for dead people.
I see dead people.
A lot of the cemeteries in London were filling up and they had no space to go, and so two massive graveyards were built outside of London. And so when people had passed, they were put onto these trains, taken out to the graveyards. And in fact, you had some trains that had its own dedicated funeral service. And thus that brings us to the current day London Waterloo as we know it as today. Alright, so it's day 8 of running the London Rail Map and day 4 of running South Western Railway. We're here back again at Barnes Station. Now today's route, we're heading over to none other than London Waterloo, the terminus of the South Western Railway. So the stations we're calling at today will be Putney, Wandsworth Town, Clapham Junction, Vauxhall and London Waterloo. The weather is absolutely Baltic. Storm Arwen is happening at the minute, basically cracking with day 4 of running South Western Railway. Right, so just like that, 2.07 kilometres we're here at Putney Station. Let's keep it moving because I don't want to stick around and get too cold. East Putney! Nice to see you again. So the last time that I was here was when I was running the district line. It was during Storm Alex.
So here we have at East Putney, we are 5.07 k's in.
And then to be back in this same area again, and there is yet another storm. But anyway, just around the corner from East Putney Tube Station and Putney Railway Station, as they had this form of viaduct here, it's because you had these southwestern trains that used to use this viaduct to connect with the line just below. And you do sometimes have southwestern railway trains that pass through East Putney Station. But here is a lovely vantage point of the former viaduct looking over onto the railway.
It's Jude, how did you, the confidence I was oozing out of you.
Seems like as if there's a radio show that's happening literally opposite the station. So 4.95 kilometres, we're finally here at Wandsworth Town, originally opened as Wandsworth back in the day. Above Wandsworth Town Station, you have the double arrows, like British Arrows logo thing. That's also on my leg.
Very good.
However, it looks a bit wrong. It looks a bit malnourished. I would have loved to have stayed for a chat with the radio host, but one, the weather, and two, borderline imposter syndrome. So just like that, 6.46 kilometres, Clapham Junction, a station that serves London Overground, South Western Railway, and Southern services. Who knows, maybe sometime in the future it'll be served by Northern Line trains if the Northern Line extension from Battersea Power Station takes place over to Clapham Junction. Finally, it's been future-proofed. So 9.23 kilometres we're here at Queenstown Road Station. When the station had first opened, it was known as Queen's Road, as indicated by the station building. Now at Queenstown Road Station, there is a disused platform here, which may be getting reintroduced. I imagine because of all the developments and things that are taking place in the area, the platform capacity here just isn't big enough. We've got two stations left, so we've got Vauxhall, and then the last station of the day, London Waterloo. What's also in the vicinity of Queenstown Road Station is, of course, Battersea Park Station, which also means we're in the vicinity of Battersea Power Station. Battersea Power Station Squared. Battersea Power Station. So 11.71 kilometres are here at Vauxhall Station. I'm just on the other side of the main entrance because, one, it's busy. And two, it's busy. Taking the word Vauxhall, it is actually a Russian word. In Russian, it translates to railway station.
Railway station.
Vauxhall.
So at this point now, we have one more station left, London Waterloo, the last and final station of this run today. Even with all the cold weather and the wind and everything, I've really enjoyed this run. It has been so much fun. Anyway, let's head over to Waterloo. And just like that, 14.31 kilometres, we're here at the last station of the day, London Waterloo. What a windy, wet run that was. A massive thank you to those that support me on Patreon. If you do want to show your support, check out the link in the description, runderground.run, as well as my merch site and social media. That will be in the link down below. See you next time.